The mountain, it's on totally on fire.
There are many fires burning at the same time on our planet. I would like to show you some of them. I would also like to show you how the Bible predicted these fires and much worse fires to come.
An entire town has been forced to evacuate as this massive California brush fire continues to spread.
39 square miles have been scorched.
Fire has forced 4,000 from their homes as flames threaten power lines to Yosemite National Park.
Everybody's scared. You'd never think something like this would happen in your town.
Thousands of residents are forced out of their homes as firefighters work to contain a dangerous wildfire near Yosemite National Park.
This fire raging all night. You can see just how much land has been charred here.
Overnight, an entire town evacuated. More than 1,400 firefighters battling a 54,000-acre fire threatening 1,500 structures, including homes.
I haven't seen these conditions in a long time. It's a wind-driven, slope-driven, fuel-driven fire.
Adding to the challenge, the fire's rapidly changing conditions, keeping firefighters on the move.
I don't think we can emphasize enough how active and erratic this fire activity is, especially with this fire. It's done stuff that we haven't seen before.
Из фильма про апокалипсис.
At the same time that we have these fires, other parts of Earth are experiencing extreme cold temperatures. Here is a news page from July 20th, 2017. It says Brazil experienced record low temperatures and even snow. Here's another news website translated into English. This page says that Argentina has suffered its worst snowfall in 22 years. And this snow brought with it an absolute record of temperatures. Understand that the planet is breaking records in cold extremes. While some parts of our planet are getting hotter, other parts of the planet are getting colder. So, that means we are having global warming and global cooling at the same time. So while we have fires and heat in the northern hemisphere, at the same time in the southern hemisphere, we're having extreme cold and snow. And please refer to the NASA report. They said that water is the strongest greenhouse gas. But here is the real reason behind all destruction on our planet. Our sin. God will clean the earth using fire and fervent heat, melting the elements. This is how he will clean the planet and start over.
The first angel sounded, and there followed hail and fire mingled with blood. And they were cast upon the earth, and the third part of trees was burnt up, and all green grass was burnt up.
The prophet Joel also gave a prophecy about fire at the sound of the trumpet.
O Lord, to thee will I cry, for the fire hath devoured the pastures of the wilderness, and the flame hath burned all the trees of the field. The beasts of the field cry also unto thee, for the rivers of waters are dried up, and the fire hath devoured the pastures of the wilderness. Blow ye the trumpet in Zion, and sound an alarm in my holy mountain. Let all the inhabitants of the land tremble, for the day of the Lord cometh, for it is nigh at hand. A day of darkness and of gloominess, a day of clouds and of thick darkness, as the morning spread upon the mountains, a great people and a strong, there hath not been ever the like. Neither shall be any more after it, even to the years of many generations. A fire devoureth before them, and behind them a flame burneth. The land is as the Garden of Eden before them, and behind them a desolate wilderness. Yea, and nothing shall escape them.
At the first trumpet, a fire will burn much of the earth. All green grass will be burned, and a third of the trees will be burned with fire.
But the day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night, in the which the heavens shall pass away with a great noise, and the elements shall melt with fervent heat. The earth also and the works that are therein shall be burned up.
Sirs, what must I do to be saved? And they said, Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved.